Environmental journalism started in Nigeria in recent couple of years, around 1984, 85. But before then, it started, you had some reporters, pockets of reporters here and there, reporting issues on maybe drought, desertification, flooding, but there was no coherent, consistent and systematic reporting of environmental issues. And there was no specialization on the beats. So you had reporters who maybe was reporting judiciary or government now taking issue of flooding occasionally, or judiciary now going into other sectors of the economy. But from the mid 80s, when the regime of Babangida, General Babangida came into power, and there was this, there was the creation of the Guardian newspaper, and the Guardian was created by late Mr. Dr. Alex Ibru, whose main objective was to have a kind of intellectual newspaper that would be able to reach the intelligentsia, the academia, the civil society, a kind of newspaper that was not that Nigerians were not used to, which was really urban, cosmopolitan, you know, a newspaper that would be accepted globally. And it had first-class journalists that were taking it to different beats, judiciary reporting, economy, business, banking, science and environment, then property, and there were specialized beats. So, but the Nigerian audience were not actually ready until the dumping of toxic waste in a place called Koko in Ben Delta State by a dubious Italian called Gianfranco Raffaelli. And so Nigeria was a chairman of Organization of African Unity, now called AU. At that time, Nigeria went to African Union in Addis Ababa and was saying to the global community that Africa will not take toxic waste terrorism. But unknown to them, the dubious Italian had shipped toxic waste to a sleepy port in Koko in Old Ben Delta State. So the Guardian reporter, the science editor then, his name is Seun Ogunseyitan, with another reporter called Mike Ogbeide. They were on the Sunday desk that I report for. And they went to Koko secretly. As a matter of fact, the Vanguard newspaper blew the story, but they were not sure. They just put question mark on the story. Toxic waste in Nigeria, they put question mark. But the Guardian silently, being a newspaper that specialized and also does a lot of investigations before the report, went to the sleeping port of Koko, took pictures of these toxic drums, I think over 2,000 tons of hazardous materials, took the pictures, and on Sunday morning, General Babangida woke up to see that toxic waste was actually in Nigeria. And that was the birth of modern environmental protection in Nigeria. It was scandalous. The government was shocked, and led to a lot of outcry. The Italian was hunted. He ran away, but the government was stern, and they made sure that the waste was shipped back to Italy, including the soil, the contaminated soil in Koko. And actually, that led to the birth of the Federal Environmental Protection Agency, which Dr. Evans I know headed, and with Major Maman Kotangora was in charge of environment. And I used to travel with them to Koko to see how that the waste was shipped. So Nigerians now became so aware that, look, that there are dangerous things out there in the environment. So people now began to buy any newspaper that carries stories on the environment or hazardous materials. So gradually, at that time, I was reporting the environment, but we were very few. And I'm one of the few people still standing reporting the environment decades after. And but now we have a lot of people, a lot of young people reporting the environment. Yeah, that's the beginning.